I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, and with the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became one. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered, died, and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again with glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, apostolic church. I confess my baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come.
Amen.
Let us ask God our Father to increase our faith and steer into flame the gift of the Holy Spirit so that we may love us, His faithful servants, in trust, we pray. Lord, increase our faith.
Lord, increase our faith. May our religious and political leaders see themselves as servants entrusted with the care of these people and so serve them with care. May they not get discouraged when their work is not appreciated, but rely on the goodness of the Lord. We pray.
Lord, increase our faith.
May the Lord prosper the works of our hands, give us a bountiful harvest, comfort the sick and the dying, and banish kidnapping and terrorism in our land. We pray.
Lord, increase our faith.
May we steer into flame God's gift of the Spirit and give witness to our faith by working for peace and solidarity in our family and community. We pray.
Lord, increase our faith.
In celebration of the National Teachers Month, may all teachers, stewards in educating and shaping the youth for a better future, continue to be more zealous in their profession. We pray.
Lord, increase our faith.
May the faithful departed now experience the joy of God's banquet in heaven, which He has prepared for His good and faithful servants. We pray.
Lord, increase our faith. Hear our petitions, Father, and deepen our faith as we continue our journey unto your kingdom. Make our faith strong, our humility deep, and our love sincere. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of his holy church.
Accept, O Lord, we pray, the sacrifice instituted by your commands, and through the sacred mystery which we celebrate with dutiful service, graciously complete the sanctifying work by which you are pleased to redeem us. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For by this birth, he brought renewal to humanity's fallen state, and by his suffering canceled out our sins. By his rising from the dead, he has opened the way to eternal life. And by ascending to you, O Father, he has unlocked the gates of heaven. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim. Mystery of faith.
Amen.
as we celebrate the memorial of His death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, you gather into one with the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church is spread throughout the world and bring it to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, Benaventura, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that we, the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, our spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, Saint Martin, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we merit to be coerced in the life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in name of God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, our glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Let us ask, increase our faith, Lord. Thank you. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold Him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Of the Father's glory, High Priest of the new and the everlasting covenant,
You who empower the bishop, the whole clergy, and the religious to be lasting signs of your presence in the world. You who send them to spread the good news of all the people of goodwill. Respond. Holy Spirit, Lord and Giver of life, it is you who bestow strength to all the faithful. It is from you that we yearn for the coming of God's kingdom here on earth as it is in heaven. It is you who inspire us with your sevenfold gifts to march closer towards the threshold of salvation and rest in the arms of the Father's merciful embrace. Response. All glory to the Father who made us like himself. Glory to the Son who saved us by his death. Glory to the Spirit who creates the world anew. Receive our humble prayer. Draw us back to you. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Saint Paul the First Hermit, Our Lady of Mercy, Saint Martin Patron of the Sick,
grant us, Almighty God, that we may be refreshed and nourished by the sacrament which we have received, so as to be transformed into what we consume. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated for some announcements. Una, yung buong aking report sa ating mong pinapakisip ko sa altar. So last time, sinabi ko na yung pumasok ay 53,000. So, pasensya na kayo na 52,500 ang sapagkat yung isa kita ng family is only 500, no? Not 1,000. So, 52,000. And then the total reimbursement ay 53,720. So 52,500 minus 53,720, divisi tayo ng 1,220. Ito naman nakalipas na linggo, may pumasok naman ang pamilya Kapimpin, 1,000. Ang pamilya Hardin, 1,000. So 2,000 minus 1,120 equals 780. Kung may kaso na mo tayo na 780. Hinihintay pa po natin yung ating pinag-holding. Hindi pa dumarating. Inaayos pa rin natin yung ibang mga bagay. And then yung pong ating lorry, hindi po tayo nakapapintura ng mga nakalipas na araw sabagkat umuulan. So kanina lang po tayo nakapapintura ng flooring natin. Kung napapasalamat po tayo sa mga Knights of the Altar, sina Alex, Sammy, Joshua, Justin, para po unti-unti natin mapintura na may repaint natin yung ating ang flooring. So at the same time, no, para maalis yung mga molds. So second ay yung buong panyaya natin para po doon sa parish share ng Holy Land ay tsaka na po i-announce. Noong Biyernes po nagkaroon kami ng orientation. Ang particular na pupuntahan po namin ay the Kingdom of Jordan and the State of Israel. So, ito yung mga biblical places na sa dalawang lugar na ito. Bagamat hindi pa po talaga yung kabuuan, kasi sinabi natin Holy Land medyo malawa. Tulad na po ng panyaya, sana rin po ay makadagdag ito ng pananampalataya, ng aking pananampalataya. Sa inyo, pero may bahagi ko rin sa inyo later on sa yung experience. Pangatlo ay yung pong ating mga teachers, yung pong mga teacher, pwede yung tumayo dito sa harapan yung mga teacher, mga guru, mga instructor, mga professors, meron ba? Kasi ngayon ay Teachers Month, Month of October, na binahagi rin po sa ating panalangin. Kung hindi po ako nagkakamali, October 7 is the International Teachers Day. May teacher po sa inyo? Ating ipagdarasal, dito po, huwag kayo mahiyak sa harapan. Yung pong mga teacher. So, ipanalangin natin. Ipanalangin din natin yung mga teacher natin. No? So, sa'yo, come forward. Diyan po siya. Sige pa. Hindi pa po. Sino mga... Lapit po, ma'am. Lapit. Hindi naman kayo mga... Sige po, dito po. Huwag kayo mahiyak. At ipagdarasal po natin sila, kasama ang mga teacher. So, may tatlo. May tatlo tayong teacher. Teachers. So, dulog po natin. Giver of all wisdom and great and greatest of all teachers, look upon our teachers with love. Grant them the resolve to nurture our eager minds and to never give up on who fall behind. Bless their hearts, for they rejoice when we succeed and encourage us when we fall. Endow them with gentle patience, for the path of learning is never easy. Kindle a spirit of passion in them. It is the flame that qualifies the love of learning in us. Help them see the potential in each student. Their belief in us means much more than the grade we make. Instill in them a commitment to keep on learning. It shows us to not fear new knowledge and experiences. Inspire them to touch the flame, to touch the future. They influence how big a dream we dream for ourselves. Bless our teachers who have come before for their endure to this day. Let the light of your example shine upon all teachers, to build up with their words, to love with their mind, to share with their heart. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Amen. Bahagi sila ng ating buhay hanggang sa ngayon. Let us all stand. Maraming salamat po sa inyong patuloy na pagsuporta sa ating mga programa at mga proyekto. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down and ask for God's blessing. May the weakness of your devoted people stir your compassion, O Lord, we pray. And let their faithful pleading win your mercy, that while they do not presume upon their marriage, they may receive by your generous pardon. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
May the Almighty God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go with the love and mercy.